when you can actually see your profit for the year in dollars and cents, it gets you more in the notion of selling corn, knowing that I can lock in a $50,000 profit or whatever the profit is. You want to lock it in. If I know I can make that much profit in a year, I will be in business next year.
Good afternoon. Welcome to Grain TV. It's September 20th, 2013. I'm Logan Burgess. To my right here is Brock Chimino to help break down the action that we saw on a Friday in the grain market. Hopping into Fire Tip here, you can see a lot of red on the board. We were down 8.25 cents for December corn, down 23.5 cents for soybeans. Chicago wheat finally found a little bit of weakness after a week of pretty good gains, down 11 cents there. Brock, it really seemed though like soybeans remains the big story here, certainly the leader to the downside. What did we see in today's action?
You know, we saw all three grains really move to the downside here today. Like you said, wheat was taking some profits off the table after four straight days of gains. Corn, we moved quite a bit lower as well today. You know, that's the lowest point we've hit on corn since August 13th. And for soybeans, really the story remains there. We continue to slip to the downside after last week's report.
Right.
We hit the lowest point since August 22nd on that contract. If you take a look at this daily chart here, candlestick daily chart of the November contract, you can see the line that we have drawn in there was that support level that we were looking at that was right at the top, or excuse me, the bottom side of that gap, right around 1331.5. Today, we finally broke through there with some very good conviction.
Yeah.
It kind of leaves the open to the downside down to about $13 or so on this daily soybean contract. And really, there's not a whole lot holding it up at this point.
You know, if we do have technical support kind of in sight right now around $13 a bushel, I mean, besides this technical support, where's the bullish story going to come from? It really seems like right now, looking at this market, the bears certainly this week and since the report, they have really been in control.
Yeah, it does seem like the bears are taking control of this market right now. We've had substantial losses this week. You know, if I was going to venture a guess at where the next bullish story could come from, we do have the quarterly grain stocks coming up at the end of the month here.
Yep.
We do have the USDA WASDE report in October, but between now and then, we don't really have a lot of information that's going to put a little bit of a bid underneath this market.
Yeah, certainly. We'll have to keep an eye on weather, but that's becoming less of a story here as the weeks move on, even to the point where dry weather seems to be weighing on the market a little bit just because it's going to speed up harvest progress. But we'll keep you posted on the fundamentals on this market. Certainly, looking at the cash market here on a Friday, we had a lot of weakness there as well. Corn basis on average was down 15 cents. And you can see here from the map, it was pretty widespread throughout the week. Soybeans lost even more in terms of cents per bushel, down 30 cents on average. Really not a huge surprise in terms of the losses that we saw this week. As we've been talking about a lot here on Grain TV, we're having a massive convergence between those old crop bids and the new crop bids. A lot of elevators right now have actually even pulled their September bid and are just bidding off that October new crop delivery. So as a result, we're seeing basis really collapse. And as we've been saying for a while, it's really a last call right now for people that are storing old crop still. There are some elevators that are still aggressively bidding old crop bushels, but right now those opportunities are kind of fading.
It doesn't seem like the futures markets are offering very good opportunities right now, and the cash market's starting to become very, very weak as we head into harvest, and harvest ramps up, and especially next week when we should get some dry weather moving through the Midwest, harvest should start to ramp up rather quickly. Do you see any opportunities out there for producers to take advantage of some cash prices?
You know, I think one interesting thing to note right now in the cash market is that there is some carry opportunity in this market, and we obviously haven't seen that in a while just given how tight ending stocks were on that 2012-13 crop. Take a look here at this table. This is showing the average cash carry between October and January for corn and soybeans. The first column here all is basically an average of every market that we're collecting right now. You can see for corn about 8 cents, soybeans about a 9 cent premium for storing till January. But take a look here at the river. We're seeing exceptional strength out of the river. And what that means for producers is that, typically for soybeans in particular, when we have a crop this tight, you should sell it off the combine. But if you have river markets at your disposal, there are some very good storage opportunities right now out there, and we can help you find those here at Grain Hedge. We have a great platform for producers to use, so if you're interested in taking a look, you can give us a call at the office. Our number is 877-472-4607, but you know, really the bottom line is that a lot of guys are going to be selling off the combine as there's not a big storage incentive, but there are some elevators right now that are really aggressively bidding that January that January delivery for soybeans in particular?
You know, these markets seem a little bit counterintuitive, like you were mentioning. You know, soybeans is going to be a short crop here this year.
Yeah.
You would think that you would be selling it right off the combine. Looks like it's going to be converse to what we were originally thinking there.
Yeah.
You know, corn, we should be holding it and storing it a little bit longer, but it looks like you could get some good opportunities right off the combine as well right now.
Yeah, absolutely. We'll help keep you posted on cash market movers here in the weeks to come. But, you know, bottom line, certainly saw a lot of weakness for soybeans in particular this week. We'll have to see what we get next week. But really, as you said, Brock, not a lot of new fundamental information besides the normal reports. Wednesday, we'll get EIA ethanol. Thursday, export sales. In the meantime, though, we'll help keep you posted on everything driving the grain market on Grain TV. Have a great weekend. We'll see you back here on Monday.